Hello again, Mr. Taru. As promised, I'm going to show you with the TI-84 or 83 how to make a regression line with your calculator. Now, when we make a regression line with our calculator, we're trying to make a linear model, which means that we need to double check that it's actually linear by making something called a residual plot. So let me quickly run through this again. A regression line, the purpose of it is to predict y values based on some x values, or predict some response variables by the explanatory variable x. So here we have the regression line, y hat equals a plus bx, y hat is read as the predicted y value, a is going to be the y-intercept, you might think of y equals mx plus b from your algebra class, the constant is the y-intercept, and the number in front of x, in this case slope, is going to be slope. So b is the slope, which is the average change in y per one unit of change in x. That is the definition of slope you want to use when dealing with word problems and applications, not the basic rise over run that we use in algebra. The y-intercept rarely has a real application in terms of statistics problems, whereas the slope will always have a real-life application, and therefore you need to read the examples in your textbook to be able to interpret what the slope is. And basically just take out y and replace it with whatever the response variable is in your word problem, and take out the word, take out the x and replace it with whatever verbiage is good for the problem you're doing at the moment. So again, slope is average change in y per one unit of change in x. In a scatter plot, the actual y value is labeled as x and y, and the predicted y values from the regression line are going to be x and y hat. The vertical distance between the regression line and our actual points are going to be measured. Those vertical distances, those vertical errors from our predicted y values, are y minus y hat, and the sum of those residuals always equals zero. And we place the line to minimize the sum of those residuals squared. And now that I've touched that, I think I might have gotten it out of the screen. There we go. So anyway, you might have already watched this video. So how about the notes about regression lines and residuals. So how do we make this regression line with a calculator, and how do we come up with the residual plot to verify that the pattern is indeed linear that we thought was linear in the first place with an 84? So I'm going to turn this on and hit clear. Now you would do stat, edit, and I've just got a few numbers in here for x and y. You, of course, with these word problems in our textbooks, will have many more values. But remember, the x-axis, which doesn't have to be list 1, is the explanatory variable, and I'm going to use list 2 as my response variable, or my y-axis. Okay, so my data's in the calculator, and if you need some basic use of a calculator, you can watch my video about histograms, box plots, and I do a lot of very detailed explanation of how to put the numbers in the calculator. But ours are already in here. So I'm going to do second stat plot, and just kind of see what's going on. Hit enter. Mine's already on. I want to choose histogram, and I want to look at the raw data, which is in list 1 and second 2 for list 2. And every time you want to make a graph with your calculator, just hit zoom 9 if you're doing a stat plot. That's zoom stat plot. Now, you're seeing that I've already done this problem in my calculator to make sure that this all works before we do this. So let me do zoom 9. Okay, so there's our scatter plot, and if I hit trace, I can go along the button to go along the individual data points and see whatever they happen to be at the bottom. And it looks like it's a linear pattern. So let's make a regression line to model that linear pattern, and then before we just blindly start using it and talk about correlation or R and R squared, let's make sure that it's actually straight as well. But it does look like it's straight. So back to the home screen, I'm going to do stat, calc. You have two choices for regression lines. In my book, and most stat books, I'm sure you're going to do, you want to use the same format it's in your book, so linreg a plus bx. Hit enter. Now don't hit enter again. You want to tell the calculator where the data is. Now mine's in list 1 and 2, so it's going to default to that, but just as practice, second L1 to tell it where the x's are, comma, which is above the 7, comma, second L2 to tell it where the y's are, comma. Now this little extra step I'm going to use is going to have the calculator automatically put the equation back into the y equals list so that the graph will show up automatically. So you hit vars, choose y vars, You're going to, you want a function, and you want to put that function where? Let's just put it in y sub 1. Now when I do that and hit enter, it's going to tell me what the y-intercept is of a, what the slope is of b. Your calculator might not be showing you r squared and r. We needed to do that. I'll tell you how to do that in a second. And if I hit y equals, there at y sub 1 is my equation. And when I hit graph, I get the line going through those points. And indeed, it does still look like we have a linear relationship. We're going to move on to a residual plot, but before we do that, what if your calculator was not telling you what r and r squared was? Well, that means you've just bought your calculator and you haven't started doing much stats with it yet. This is a one-time setup, unless all your batteries completely die and your backup battery. So just one time, let's go to catalog. So second, catalog, and we're going to scroll down. There's a faster way to do this, but I almost never use this catalog, so I don't worry about bothering with the shortcut. And we're going to scroll down until we see diagnostics on. Hit enter, and hit enter again, and that'll be the only time you have to do this. Every time now, when you come up with your regression line, and I can do second enter to pull up my last command, and do second enter to pull up my previous command, where I try to ask for the regression line. If I did enter, and of course my calculator was already giving me r and r squared, but yours will now too. Don't forget, r is the strength and direction of a linear relationship. We have a very, very close to negative 1, which means the slope is negative, and where correlation appears to be very strongly linear. R squared is going to tell us the percent or fraction of variation in y that's explained by the regression line of y on x. So r, strength and direction of a linear relationship, r squared, percent of variation of y that's explained by the variable x, or the line y on x. Okay, so we have our graph with a regression line going through it. Now that we've made the scatter plot, now that we've made our regression line, let's make a residual plot to actually make sure that that data was indeed straight. To do that, we want to look at our original x's on the x-axis down here, and our residuals now are going to be on the y-axis, or that's where we want them. So, scatter plot, regression line. Now, when you make that line, the calculator makes all your residuals for you and puts them in a list. So, I'm back to the home screen, and I'm going to go to list, second, list. And after you have the calculator make the regression line, it makes a bunch of residuals for you. Let's take those residuals and put them somewhere we can use them. So store, put them in an empty list in your stat edit menu, which in my case is list 3. Hit enter. And now when I go to stat edit 4, I only had 2 columns of data. Now I've got 3. The original x's, the original y's, and the residuals. Y minus y hat. These are all the vertical distances. These y values are from our predicted regression line, our predicted y values. Now, a residual plot is the original x's over the residuals. The original x's on the x-axis still, the y's are now going to be the residuals. So I want to make a new scatter plot, so second stat plot, hit enter, and I want to keep my x's where they are, but the y's I want to replace with the residuals, which are in list 3, and zoom. Okay, when you do that, hit clear, try again, zoom 9. What I want to see in a residual plot is no curving pattern. You can easily have a scatter plot on this small, if there's high definition, low definition screen, you can easily have a scatter plot look like it's straight when it actually is not. A residual plot will magnify any curvature that was in the original scatter plot that you then drew the line through. Sometimes we can deal with these residuals because they're so small that they do not have any real life application. But generally you do not want your residual plot to show any curved pattern. Now one pattern I am seeing is as my x's got bigger, my residuals got smaller, and there's almost like a sideways cone shape. That might not be okay with some problems, but what you really do not want to see is a curved pattern in your residual plot. That means your regression line was not a good model. We do not have a curved pattern, so our linear model was a good fit. If you hit Window, You can see the scale, the min and max of the x-axis can be set by the original x values. And my y-min and y-my-max are pretty small values, just to say. So we have our residuals ranging from negative 0.7 to positive 0.5, or at least is how the window is defined. And that's it. Bam! I can't yell bam really loud with the camera right next to my face, but that is how you use your TI-83 and 84 to make a regression line. Well, let's go back. To make a regression line and a scatter plot. Let's go back to the original data. Zoom 9. So there's our original scatter plot. There's our regression line going through it. After making that regression line, the calculator stored the residuals in a list. We pulled those out. We stored them in a useful place. And then made the residual plot to verify that the pattern was indeed actually linear. So there you go. How to use your graphing calculator, at least if it's an 83 or 84 TI. Hope good luck with your homework.